Hi everyone, this is Pedram, and in this video I want to talk about Google Colab basics. Basically, how to write a text or code in a Colab notebooks, how to run it, and how to use auto completion. Okay, so this is where we left off last time. We opened the Google Colab Jumpstart notebook from my GitHub repository and we made a copy on our own Google Drive. So this was the Google Drive, and if I go back one folder up, so remember this Google, the Colab notebooks are going to be saved here. Now this is our own version, our own copy of the original version. So now I can make some changes to this file. Now, instead of me going over this notebook and you watching it, I want you to go ahead and open a new Colab and try to replicate these things from scratch. So the way to do it is go to File and New Notebook. And you can name it whatever you want. So for example, let's give it some time to be loaded. Right now it is untitled. If I go back to my Google Drive, you'll see that there's this new notebook here. And you can call it anything. Let's go ahead and call it Basics. So the goal is to replicate, let's say, these cells and Python codes in a new notebook from scratch. So let's do it. Let's start at the very top. So we can add a code cell or a text cell. So for example, I can add a text cell below. So I say this is a test, and I can give it some headings with doing pounds heading, and then I can run it by doing shift enter. And so this is my text cell. I can move it up or down. So if I click on it and press this one, it's going to move up. Move it up or down, right? So this is how we do a text cell. Then imagine you want to do a Python thing. So we just talked about these ones, the cell code. And now let's make a Python code. I'm going to go back here. I say, okay, imagine I'm making a variable x is equal to 2 plus 2. And then I can do control enter to run it and stay at the same cell. And by the way, the reason that it's taken a little longer for the first time, because it was dedicating a virtual machine to me. It was connecting. Now the X is there. I can make a new cell and then print out X, right? So I say X and shift enter. If I do control enter, it's going to run the cell and stay there. If I do shift enter, it's going to run the cell and go to the next cell. If I do alt enter, it's going to run the code, run the cell and basically go to the, make a new cell below. Okay, so these are very small nuances and differences that maybe it's a good idea to learn them. Okay, now we have a Python cell. So we know how to add a text cell, how to add a Python cell. Let's see, what else do we have? Okay, imagine you want to write some mathematical formula in your text, right? You want to replicate something like this. How can I do that? First of all, you can double click on any of the cells and then see how it's written. But if you want to do it on your own, so this is the language that's used in a text cell is Markdown. So this means that if I go back here and I want to add, let's go ahead, for example, delete this cell and delete this one too and make a new text cell. Okay. So this is Markdown language. And for example, I can go ahead and put two stars before and after a word to make it bold. And if, sorry, if I do shift enter, I'll see what's happening here. Okay. And there are so many useful documentation out there when it comes to Markdown language. And it's just Google Markdown guide. And then there's going to be tons of cheat sheets for you. So for example, if I want to itemize things, I want to say, okay, put star item one. Star, I can do star item two. You have to do a space in between. And etc. And pay attention as I'm typing things, and it's going to show up on the right hand side. Okay. The next thing that you can do is to add a mathematical formula in a very good looking way. So for example, let's go ahead and add a regression equation. Okay. So we can go ahead, if you do dollar sign, open close dollar sign, it's going to put it in a mathematical formula, right? So right now I can do y is equal to, then I need to do, for example, beta 0 plus beta 1 as a coefficient of regression, right? So I can do backslash beta. And as you can see, as soon as I start typing backslash, it's gonna make some suggestions. Beta underscore zero plus backslash beta underscore one x one and etc. Right? I can go ahead and add a noise as well with epsilon. Okay, let's do backslash epsilon. Okay, and as you can see, this is how it's gonna look like at the end of the day, right? And I can make this mathematical formula, I can center it and put it in the next line. And if you want to do that, you have to do $2. So if I go ahead and add $1 at the beginning and $1 at the end, this is how it's going to look like. Okay. So now we know how we can make a code cell, how we can make a text cell, how we can write mathematical equation in a text cell using Markdown language. All right. So we talked about how we can move cells up and down. Let's go ahead and work with some Python and see what is the auto completion in Python. But before me going over the auto completion, I want to show you some very cool feature when it comes to using Google Colab, and that's how it can help you with troubleshooting your errors. So let me actually go ahead and do some Python code. I want to say let's say y is equal to 1. And let's go ahead and calculate or print out. Well, this is notebook. You don't need to write prints. It's going to do the job automatically. So if I want to do 1 divided by 1 minus y, well, the answer is going to be the infinity, right? Because 1 divided by 0 is infinity or undefined. So I will get an error. So let's run it and see what happens. Oops, sorry. You know, I have to make sure that I use the right parentheses. So we need to open close parentheses here and here. So let's run it. Okay, I will get an error, right? Because it's the zero division error. And imagine you're coding and you get an error like this and you want to just Google it. No, it is very convenient that Google Colab is going to put his search Stack Overflow button here. When you click on it, it's going to go ahead and search the same thing, the error that you got in Stack Overflow. So this is a very, very convenient way that you can troubleshoot your code in Google Colab. All right, then another thing that I want you to pay attention is that sometimes when you're running a Python code, it's gonna get stuck in a while loop or something like that. You know, the algorithm doesn't converge. And you'll see that the cell has been running for a while and it's not doing anything. So if you get something like this, let me show you an example. So imagine we are writing a while loop. And we say, okay, x is equal to 5. And we say, as long as x is positive, just add one number to your x, right? So this is like x plus the 1, save it to x, right? So this is a Python short notation for that, right? So then if I run this cell, it's never going to stop, right? Because my x is always positive, and it's going to continue doing that. So how we can interrupt this? You can simply press on this button. And sometimes if this doesn't work, go ahead and go to the runtime and interrupt execution. Okay. So this is how we can interrupt a cell, which a Python cell, which is not converging or which is not, it's stuck in a while loop. Okay. And okay, let's move down. The next thing we want to replicate, well, you can do, the cool thing about Google Colab is this is basically your Jupyter notebook, right? You can write the Python code and see the visualization right there. So here's an example. Again, we can copy paste it from the Google Colab Jumpstart. Let's go ahead and make a new cell here, new Python cell, and then paste it, right? And we can run it. So this is the output. So this should be pretty straightforward. And by the way, if you want to imagine you want to, at the end of the day, you're writing a notebook documentation and you want to save the outputs, right? You want to get rid of the outputs. And you have to go here and click on these three dot buttons and say clear outputs. So you can go ahead and clear outputs. Okay, so these are little things that, and of course, this means that if you run this cell, you're going to get an error, and et cetera, et cetera. Okay. So the last thing I want to cover in this video is auto-completion. So this is very, very useful when it comes to coding, you know, because when you're coding, of course, you don't need to memorize all the features of a method or a function in Python. So it is very convenient if you have a documentation in hand, right? So let me go ahead and, for example, look some of the functions from NumPy package. So we're going to import NumPy as np. Now, if I go ahead and do NumPy and press period or dot, then you will see a list of available completion with the NumPy module. And completion can be opened again by using control space. So imagine you are typing code and then, you know, that auto completion is gone. If you do control space, it's going to load up again. Okay. And now you can, let's say you want to work with a random module, random. And then here, if you open a parenthesis, it's going to, well, if you open a parenthesis after any function or class in the module, you will see a pop-up of its documentation string. So this is the documentation for the random module. And for example, from this module, you can select another method. Let's do rand n. So, and then if you open parenthesis, you will see the documentation, okay? And if for whatever reason the documentation does not pop up, you can always do, control shift and space. And this should open the documentation again, okay? So we're gonna use use these documentations a lot in our courses because we wanna see what is inside each method or what is inside each class. We can get access to the code, we can have the documentation open in front of us while we're coding, okay? So for example, this function is gonna make a random number from normal distribution so if I run this, so this is going to be that number. All right, that was pretty much everything I wanted to cover in this video. So in the next one, I will cover more advanced tricks. See you in the next one.